Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Nos programmes offrent plusieurs langues. Veuillez visiter suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Nuestros programas ofrecen varios idiomas. Visiten suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Nuestros programas ofrecen varios idiomas. Acesse suprememastertv.com/schedule.
हमारे कार्यक्रम पेश किए जाते कई भाषाओं में कृपया देखें suprememastertv.com/schedule.
我们的节目提供多种语言，请看 suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Rancangan kami menawarkan banyak bahasa. Sila kunjungi suprememastertv.com/katabanschedule.
برامجنا متوفرة بال العديد من اللغات يرجى زيارة suprememastertv.com/schedule.
Наша программа предлагает много языков. Пожалуйста, посмотрите suprememastertv.com/schedule.
برنامه‌های ما شامل زبان‌های بسیاری است. از این وبسایت دیدن فرمایید suprememastertv.com/schedule.
If we keep the five precepts, doing good things, then we also evolve, but slowly, slowly. If we practice the inner heavenly light and sound, we zoom, whoop, like rocket, yeah. We leapfrog over many eons of evolutions. Wow, how nice. I'm happy to have this, yes, for you.
Please continue watching to find out more.
Supreme Master Qinghai's lectures are not a complete meditation instruction. Please do not try alone. For free of charge guidance, please visit godsdirectcontact.org or contact any of our centers near you.
Today's episode will be presented in English and Chinese, with subtitles in Arabic, Aulasis, also known as Vietnamese, Bulgarian, Chinese, Czech, English, French, German, Hindi, Hungarian, Indonesian, Italian, Japanese, Korean, Malay, Mongolian, Persian, Polish, Portuguese, Punjabi, Romanian, Russian, Spanish, Telugu, and Thai.
Alegres saludos, espectadores, amantes de la paz. Mi nombre es María Julia. El pueblo del Salvador desea que su viaje espiritual sea profundo y tranquilo, bajo la protección de Dios. El Salvador, localizado en América Central, tiene una historia antigua y las ruinas arquitectónicas muestran que los mayas, los aztecas y los indios pipiles poblaron la tierra. A pesar de su modesto tamaño, el país tiene la cuarta economía más grande de la región. Históricamente, la principal exportación era la planta de añil y fue seguida eventualmente por el café. En el 2015, El Salvador fue llamado el país que había alcanzado el progreso más grande en el mundo en términos del aumento al acceso de suministro de agua y saneamiento. El país ha producido una multitud de personas famosas, algunas de las cuales han dejado su marca internacionalmente, entre ellos el poeta Roque Dalton.
Con su rica historia, la sobresaliente belleza natural, dramáticos paisajes y gente muy amigable, esta nación centroamericana tiene un poquito de todo para todos. Desde la animada ciudad a relajarse en el sol, senderismo en la montaña y exploraciones por los bosques. Es un placer compartir con ustedes un vistazo del históricamente rico El Salvador. Optimistas espectadores, oramos a Dios para que les llene de gloria divina.
Durante más de 3 décadas, la Maestra Suprema Ching-Hai ha iluminado nuestro mundo con sus enseñanzas divinas. Una maestra totalmente iluminada, ella imparte el método Guan Yin de meditación a aquellos que desean descubrir inmediatamente la naturaleza de Dios interna y alcanzar en una vida la liberación eterna del ciclo de la transmigración.
El método Guan Yin ha sido practicado por todos los maestros iluminados, tales como Buda, Jesucristo, el profeta Mahoma, la paz sea con él, Guru Nanak y muchos más.
Ella enfatiza que si siempre recordamos a Dios, ofrecemos servicio desinteresado a otros y seguimos las leyes del universo, alcanzaremos nuestro potencial más elevado como humanos y comprenderemos verdaderamente nuestro propósito en la tierra.
La Maestra Suprema Ching-Hai es un extraordinario ejemplo viviente de compasión, enviando frecuentemente asistencia material y financiera, además de amor, a los refugiados, a los desamparados, a las víctimas de desastres naturales y a otros que necesitan ayuda. La Maestra Suprema Ching-Hai está profundamente agradecida con el amado Dios por toda la ayuda financiera, consuelo y apoyo para los afligidos y necesitados y o cualquier buena causa a través de los años como una humilde receptora para su compasión y amor hacia sus preciados hijos.
En el 2006, ella recibió el premio Guzi de la Paz, considerado el premio Nobel de la Paz de Oriente, y ha sido honrada a través de los años con otros numerosos premios y galardones por sus excepcionales obras filantrópicas y humanitarias.
Una verdadera voz para nuestros preciosos amigos animales. Ella promueve la pacífica y amorosa dieta a base de plantas y prevé, con el despertar de la humanidad hacia lo sagrado de todas las vidas, un tranquilo y glorioso mundo completamente vegano, donde los animales y las personas vivan en dichosa armonía. Sus iniciativas para difundir la tendencia vegana son diversas y han incluido la distribución del volante de vida alternativa, la cadena internacional de restaurantes veganos Loving Heart, Supreme Master Television, además de hablar regularmente con influyentes líderes de gobierno y medios de comunicación y participar en conferencias televisadas sobre el cambio climático, tanto si somos conscientes de ello como si no. Sus esfuerzos han tenido una enorme influencia sobre la conciencia mundial del estilo de vida amigable con los animales y de cómo esta benévola forma de ser puede traer paz duradera entre las naciones, a la vez que salvamos nuestro planeta del cambio climático. A lo largo de los años, la Maestra Suprema Ching-Hai ha viajado por todo el mundo, desde las Américas hasta África, desde Europa hasta Oceanía, y ha ofrecido cientos de discursos al público y a sus discípulos sobre una variedad de temas espirituales.
Hoy somos bendecidos con la presentación de una de estas reveladoras conferencias titulada
El Sutra Surangama, la influencia de los demonios en los practicantes espirituales que codician los poderes espirituales o el profundo vacío, parte 2 2005 en Entre Maestra y Discípulos, impartida en inglés y chino el 30 de diciembre de 2018 en Sihu, Taiwán, también conocido como Formosa.
We should really thank the past masters, monks and nuns and scholars who has take time to record what the Buddha's teaching after the master Nirvana. And also for the past and present persons, lay or monks or nuns who has really dedicated themselves, sacrificed their time and precious health or under any difficult situation to translate this so that I can read it to you. We have to thank them. And may they be blessed forever by all the Buddhas, past, present, and future. May their merit be immense. May they be liberated forever. Thank you. According to Buddhism and the believer and the tradition, when you read sutra and all that, you have to put on incense, flower, you know, and bow to the sutra first and thank all the Buddhas and Bodhisattva in 10 directions, all respectfully, before you read it, okay? And then you cover the sutra also with silk, or, you know, beautiful cloth, and I just make it more popular, yeah, more easy, simple. I apologize to all the Buddha. I say, if I done something wrong, according to the tradition, my heart is full of respect. It's just that I cannot always do that. So please, all the sin, whatever I've done wrong, is all on me. At least other people, they hear the names of the Buddha, according to the sutta, they will get benefit. Yes. Last time we were in the demon who are the ghost of the spirit of mountain, forest, earth, or cities, or rivers. Yeah, has become demon, so we passed that already. Because that demon will possess somebody and talk, you know, any kind of thing, and then make the spiritual practitioner behave erratically, yeah, etc., etc. And now, next one. Further on, meaning that in this state of samadhi, many of these states of mind can arise and can make you go wrong way. This is another one even. It doesn't mean everyone has the same experience of demonic influence. It's different one, different demonic influence. When you're in that state, after you have realized and got rid of the feeling skanda, then such as above mentioned may occur to you through demonic influences. Yeah, and this is another one coming. Further, in the unhindered clarity and wonder that ensues after the feeling skanda is gone, this good person is untroubled by any deviant. Ah, 再见, 一路顺风, 佛菩萨保佑, 啊, 继续教导他们四书, 念佛, okay, 再见. He has to leave, go back to China. Some places very far, and they have to take my 4, 3, 4, 5 days to arrive in Taiwan, because many changes. Buses, maybe horse cart, maybe ox cart, bus, train, you know, because some people live in remote area. It's difficult. The Chinese people, I really feel very, very touched by their devotion. They're very, very sincere. you came such a long way. Even not long way, you have to arrange your family, your business, your job, take up your whole vacation of the whole year to come. Now or several times, you know, spending your money and time to come here. Waiting at the airport, you know, struggling in the gas station, in the train station with our luggage and stuff like that. It's not easy to travel, you know, especially when you go into a wilderness like this, no hotel. If you go to a hotel, a holiday resort, it's different, yeah? Here, I don't have facilities, yeah. But I don't know how you manage. Everything okay? Bathroom, toilet, everything not bad? Yeah, really, you okay?
Yes.
I'm so sorry. I truly am sorry, but I don't know why you come so many either, you know? I did not think you come so many like that, especially winter, you know? But Christmas is time you can have a time off, so you maybe you take only 2-3 day extra holiday so you don't have to lose all your vacation time. Yeah. And also, it's good to celebrate Christmas, to remember how much all the Master sacrificed for us. Suffering, not just mentally, but physically, and all kind of aspects. So we should remember the life of Jesus and appreciate the teaching of all the Masters, past, present, or future. And we should know that even a Master so powerful, has to humbly be born in such a situation like that. The other day when there was dancing on the stage and they put my singing that in Vietnamese, in the winter night, the Son of God like born in a manger like that, you know. I say how in such a humble, you know, degraded situation, don't even have a cradle or anything that is worthy of even just a humble human, not to talk about a Son of God. And I just couldn't help to feel so emotionally sad. Not just now, every time, you know, every time I remember Jesus' story when I first came, when I was forced to take up this job, I already felt like that. All over the years, all the time, every Christmas, sometimes I cry alone in my own place. Whenever something triggered that memory, you know, from Jesus, such a powerful being, he's still helping us now. You know, and before, ever, all the time. Not just when he first left the physical body, but continue. Years after years, decades, you know, continue all the time. In the spirit as well as in physical. But it's sadly the world is still following Maya to some degree, you know, and not listen to the Master. Otherwise, we would have turned this world into paradise long, long ago. And no one ever had to suffer, even from climate change, not even that. Okay, so further in this stage, you know, after the feeling skandha is getting rid of, the good person is absolutely untroubled. His mind is clear. The mental state is perfect and bright concentration. But within his samadhi, his mind still craves spiritual powers and all manners of transformations. So he investigates the source of transformations as he greedily seeks for spiritual powers. It will come to you, you know, as you meditate, as you elevate yourself step by step to a dimension of better spiritual attainment. So do not seek, okay? Do not seek like, okay, I want to have a lot of spiritual power so I can give my transformation body, go appear this and that area to impress people and make people think that I'm a master. Don't do that. Because it won't work. It won't work. It will not work like that. It will not work just because you want it and you have transformation power or seeing, going to different Buddha land, stuff like that. It doesn't work like that, okay? Not because you want, then it happened. No, just don't want. It will come naturally, one step at a time, even without you knowing it. Best is that you don't know it. Because here, in this state of mental desires, he wants to have spiritual powers, meaning he wants to know it. Yeah, that is a trouble. You see, he wants to know that, okay, I sit here, I transform my body to maybe Taipei to see one of my friends and then impress him. It doesn't work like that. It's not the transformation body. It is all the universal mighty power to manifest in different bodies to help people. Not as your will, but as per necessity. To whomever, you know, worthy or has an affinity with you. So this person keep desiring and seeks and try all his might to investigate how to get spiritual power. It won't work when you want to have it or investigate and try to grasp it. It won't work. So at that time, because he's so greedily and desirously wanting these spiritual powers of all sorts, so at that time, the demon, a demon from the heavens, sees the opportunity it has been waiting for. Its spirit possesses another person and uses him as a mouthpiece to expound the sutras and teachings. This person, truly unaware that he is possessed by a demon, so he claimed that he has reached unsurpassed nirvana, meaning he's a Buddha already. The demon makes him think like that, using demon's power. When he comes to see that good person who seeks spiritual powers, you know, the spiritual practitioners, yeah, without guidance, or with guidance but not listening to the guidance, because too much ambition, having the habit in the world to have ambition to want this, to achieve that, to be a big shot, to be famous, to be worshipped, to be believed in. It's just natural, habit, yeah? So even when you are in such a high state of samadhi, the mind is still bothering you. So the mind, the ego, is our worst enemies, I told you, yeah? Okay. Now, this possessed person arranged a seat and explain the teachings, whatever teachings that was. The possessed person may hold fire in his hands and even hold a portion of the fire. Put a flame or put the flame on the head of each listener in the fourfold assembly. Fourfold assembly? Monks, nuns, male believers, female believers, okay? Right. Wow, because this spiritual practitioner could be a monk, you know, the one that seeks spiritual powers, yes. So this possessed person comes and sit there and talk instead of the practitioners. The spiritual practitioners who seek spiritual power already have some followers, you know, fourfold practitioners. So he seeks more spiritual power in order to prove his worth. Maybe in this kind of ambitious thinking, the demon can seize the opportunity and delude him. Because when you are monks or nuns, sooner or later, you will have some followers somehow, yeah? Some people nearby in your village or something. And if you be able to reach a second level already, you have eloquence. So people will come far and wide to listen to you. And maybe you want to be more obviously powerful. You like it very much. And there you will have trouble. The demon will come. So these fourfold assembly were listening. And this demon-possessed person will take hold of some of the fire and put on top of the head of each of the listeners. Well, I hope he don't have like 10,000 here, because you have trouble going to put one on each head. Maybe just a small assembly, huh? Yeah. Like in some temple, you know, Sunday or something, they come together, you know, worship the Buddha or listen to the monk. Then it's not that many. Then this demon-possessed person will use this magical power, take the fire and put on different people's head. Oh my God, all kind of demon have all kind of power. So that should scare you out of seeking magical studies. It can blind you. It can make you feel too good to seek the whole truth. Yeah, you're so excited with the toys that you forget to listen to the Dharma. Huh? Okay, you forget to search for the truth, Dharma. That's the problem. Ah, the flames on top of their heads are several feet high, even. Not just a little candle-like. Yet they are not hot, and no one is burned. Or he may walk on water as if on dry land. It's just one of those magical powers, yeah? Some master might have it, some not. Some have it, but don't use it. Only use it for emergency, with nobody witness. It's the best. Okay? If somebody witness your physical power, even in time of emergency, you have to pay for it. You have to pay. With your spiritual power or with your lifespan shortened. So, or he may sit motionless in the air, or he may enter into a bottle or stay in a bag, or he may pass through window panes and walls without obstruction. Master has all that. Master has more than that. The masters, they have more than that. But they don't use, or they cannot. Yeah. Only when attacked by weapons does he feel ill at ease. Okay, at least he have one weak spot. If you use a knife or gun to shoot him, maybe then he has to feel pain. Because the ghosts and not all the ghosts had the same power, and not all the ghosts are physically invincible. Understand? Huh? Therefore, this ghost has only that much. If somebody attack him with knives, then he has to, you know, withdraw or feel pain or bleed. The Buddha describing what kind of ghost. He often talks about spiritual powers and self-mastery. He may cause people to see visions of Buddha lands, but they are unreal. They are unreal. And arise merely from the ghost's power to delude people. He praises the indulgence of lust and does not condemn lewd conduct. Lewd, right? Bad conduct. Oh, God. So then you know. Even if he has all that power, you know, and he make you see the Buddha land as if the master has, as if the real master power have enabled you to do that at the time of initiation or further. But you see his teaching is completely the opposite of what's good. Yeah? Up to now, always lust and greed and all kind of bad conduct he tolerate, he encourage. That is a no-no, okay? And even the past or the present master, any master teach you any conduct that is not supposed to enable you to be a nobler person, then you know it's a no-no-no, okay? No matter what he said, no matter how much spiritual power or magical power, he, I would say, show it to you to impress you, okay? Precept, moral standard, being loving and kind and good to others are at least the basic principle of any master who has heart and spiritual attainment, okay? What's the good of a master or any Buddha if he's violating other people's life or purity in sexual misconduct or you know, stealing or doing all this kind of harmful to other people? What's the good of that Buddha if he is a Buddha? You understand what I'm saying? So the master or any Buddha has to be definitely protector of people's life, of animals' life, to lessen any possible suffering from any beings. Then you know he or she at least will not lead you to hell. Put it straight that way. Understand? Because in this world, there are law, of course, and retribution. If you transgress any of that, you go to hell. The karma Lord will not leave you alone. Terrible. He praises the indulgence of lust and does not condemn lewd conduct. He uses indecent means to transmit his teaching. See that? It's truly a ghost. Yeah. This is a powerful nature spirit, a mountain sprite, a sea sprite, a wind sprite, or a river sprite, an earth sprite, or a grass and tree sprite even. Even grass has sprite. That's why, it's me speaking now, okay. That's why in the Buddha's time, when you take the Bodhisattva precept, the Buddha even tell you not to play on grass, not to play in water, not to step on grass. They have sprite. They might harm you if you trample on their property, on their house. Or grass and trees sprite. That has evolved over long ages. See, they evolved, even ghosts evolved. If they don't do anything wrong, then they can also evolve, just like us human beings. If we keep the five precepts, doing good things, then we also evolve, but slowly, slowly. If we practice the in the heavenly light and sound, we zoom, whoop, like rocket, yeah. We leapfrog over many eons of evolutions. Wow, how nice. I'm happy to have this, yes, for you.
Gentiles espectadores, gracias por acompañarnos en el programa de hoy titulado El Sutra Surangama, la influencia de los demonios en los practicantes espirituales que codician los poderes espirituales, o El Profundo Vacío, parte 2 de 5, en Entre Maestra y Discípulos.
Por favor, sigan con nosotros en Supreme Master Television para más programación positiva. A continuación sigue El Beneficio de la Práctica Espiritual, parte 4 de 5, en Palabras de Sabiduría, después de Noticias de Interés.
Que siempre estén bendecidos.
con el amor y la protección celestiales. May you always be blessed with heavenly love and protection.
Our programs offer many languages. Please visit suprememastertv.com/schedule and suprememastertv.com/BMD.
Nos programmes offrent plusieurs langues. Veuillez visiter suprememastertv.com/schedule et suprememastertv.com/BMD.
Nuestros programas ofrecen varios idiomas. Visiten suprememastertv.com/schedule y suprememastertv.com/BMD.
Nossos programas oferecem vários idiomas. Acesse suprememastertv.com/schedule e suprememastertv.com/BMD.
हमारे कार्यक्रम पेश किए जाते हैं कई भाषाओं में. कृपया देखें suprememastertv.com/schedule और suprememastertv.com/BMD.
我们的节目提供多种语言，请看 suprememastertv.com/schedule 和 suprememastertv.com/BMD.
Rancangan kami menawarkan banyak bahasa. Sila kunjungi suprememastertv.com/keharapan-schedule dan suprememastertv.com/keharapan-BMD.
برامجنا متوفرة بالعديد من اللغات. يرجى زيارة suprememastertv.com/schedule و suprememastertv.com/BMD.
Наша программа предлагает много языков. Пожалуйста, посмотрите suprememastertv.com/schedule и suprememastertv.com/BMD.
برنامه های ما شامل زبان های بسیاری است. از این وبسایت ها دیدن فرمایید suprememastertv.com/schedule و suprememastertv.com/BMD.